Hello, I am Sharon Beekman, Chair of the EPC Women's Resource Council. The Council administers the EPC Women's Ministry called the Well Women's Resources. We exist to serve you, women in EPC churches, and we want to help you connect with the EPC women across our denomination and to provide resources for ministry in the local church. Please visit our website, blog, and Facebook group. The link to the blog and Facebook can be found on the EPC website. On the website, you'll also find vetted resources on discipleship, evangelism, healing, prayer, and leadership. We selected ones to help you grow in your love for Christ, to be bold in your faith, and to be equipped to serve Him. The resources are biblically based and theologically sound. In our video series, council members want to bless you as they share personal experiences and insights in their journey with Christ. I hope you will be blessed now by a conversation between Heidi Bethel and Joanne Stenstrom as they discuss the importance of the local church in the life of a believer.
We have been talking so much about the importance of the local church, and not just church membership or even church attendance, but being embedded in the life of the local church. Mm-hmm. So what would you say, what to you is a definition of the local church?
Let's take a look at the local church as a gathering of people who love Jesus and submit to Him as Lord and Savior. It's a group of people who come together to worship, who come together to study the scriptures, have fellowship, and pray for one another. Mm-hmm. And Jesus used it as His witness to the world. Bonhoeffer, as you might recall, called the church the visible body of Christ when it worships together.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you hear people say, but wait, can't I do all of that on my own? Can't I worship God and pray and even have devotionals on my own and maybe show up every now and then, but on a Sunday morning, if it's beautiful, go for a beautiful hike and worship? Or sometimes I just want to relax and do yard work and worship. Why is it so important to be at church involved?
We both have heard this from other people and probably even felt it ourselves sometimes. But you know, we're told in scripture, in Hebrews 10 specifically, to not neglect the worshiping together. That is very, very important to the body of Christ. And we are specifically told to come together to encourage one another in love and good works.
It's true that we can worship throughout the week, and how special it is to worship in a beautiful setting. Really, there are no examples in the New Testament of people growing in Christ on their own. It's always in groups that we're shown so many examples of.
That's right. And remember that Paul's epistles were written to individual churches, not to individuals. And it's a place where we are strengthened, we're nourished, and even transformed.
That's a great reminder. And when you think about it, we were created for community by a relational and a triune God. God has given every single person a spiritual gift to be used within the context of the local church for the encouragement of everyone. There's a verse in 1 Corinthians 12:13 that says, "For in one spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greek, slaves or free, and all were made to drink of one spirit." This verse emphasizes both the unity and diversity of believers. We're different, yet we're one body. But bodies are useless without life, and the church needs to be full of people who are spiritually alive.
And one of the ways that we are spiritually alive is Paul teaches us that we are to love one another, forgive one another, encourage one another, even confront one another, and bear one another's burdens. And that reminds me of a quote from John Piper where he says, sanctification is a community project, not an individual project.
Which brings us to Sunday school and Bible studies. Sunday school isn't in the Bible. Why is it so important that we go to Sunday school? Well, we know the Bible tells us, like you just said, that we are to study the Bible both individually and in groups, and this helps us to learn from each other, gain insights from each other, but also to correct bad theology if needed.
Exactly. And you know, we're also told to make disciples. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that on our own. We have to do that through the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. And we are encouraged, we are taught mm-hmm. in our Sunday school classes, mm-hmm. in our Bible study groups, in our small community mm-hmm. groups, and just encouraged with one another. As you said, the spiritual gift, we're encouraging one another all along that way. And again, that idea that we have many buildings mm-hmm. that we call church, mm-hmm. but there's one church, and that church is Jesus Christ.
That's right.
And Jesus taught by example. Mm-hmm. We need to look at how he discipled others. Mm-hmm. He taught a few men who then replicated that in discipling others. He taught by example, mm-hmm. and we need to live our life an example of him as he loved and served others. And that's how we begin to make disciples.
That's right. And when you think about it, the church is a family. It's not an audience. And if you're just sitting in the pew, even on a weekly basis and not involved, you're really just a consumer there to get out what you want to get out of it.
Exactly.
But the body of Christ is a family, and the families are relational.
That's right.
And at church, you're surrounded by your brothers and sisters in Christ.
Mm-hmm. And I like what you used in the consumerism, mm-hmm. being a consumer at the church, but we need to be communers mm-hmm. so that we're communing right. in worship mm-hmm. with one another. Mm-hmm. We're just not individuals. We are a body of Christ.
That's right. Let's go back to the passage in Hebrews 10. That was so on our hearts, has been on both of our
yes.
hearts as we've been thinking about
right.
this. Paul David Tripp says that that passage serves to remind us that corporate worship is designed to remind us of our identity in Christ, so
exactly.
that we're not looking for identity in other things,
exactly.
especially as we struggle. I have found this to be so true in my life, whether I'm a new mom
mm-hmm.
receiving meals
mm-hmm.
or new in my church when I was new and got to know so many women through a small group and Bible study, or being there on Sunday mornings or when the church doors are open to hear a good sermon, learn through Sunday school lessons.
Mm-hmm.
God has shown his faithfulness and grace through my church community.
Absolutely. And it's in that body, that local church body, the body of Christ, mm-hmm. we were strengthened, we're mm-hmm. nourished, and maybe even transformed.
Mm-hmm.
And as we think about worshiping together, George Barnes said that worship is not an event. He said it's a lifestyle
mm-hmm.
that we need to build into our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And he also mentioned that we are called not to go to church, mm-hmm. but to be mm-hmm. the church.
So basically, the church needs us, and
we need the church.
I hope this discussion has been a blessing to you. For more information on The Well, please see our website and blog and connect with us on social media. Thank you for watching, and may God richly bless you today.